party yet. Not party yet.
Hello, welcome to MP Hacker. You know, I have this stereo here, which has some nice features. It's really old, and it has CD. It has actually cassette. Yeah, it's somewhat broken. And it has radio, but the antenna is also broken. So what can we use this for? We can listen to CD. Yes, we can, but we cannot listen to our MP3 collection. So what can we do to that? Let's hack with NP. To start, you must open the player up. This screw seems to be pretty easy. No, it isn't. Yeah, sorry, I was used to screwing in the wrong direction. Place the screw somewhere where they are secure. And go to the next one. Here we will also find a screw. And on the other side as well. There is some screws left, like here, but my screwdriver isn't long enough for the screw, and this screw hole is too small. My screwdriver won't fit in there, so I won't go get those screws open. It's like 1, 2, 3, 4. Also, remember this screw here. That's almost. Yeah, you see the screw under the antenna. You should not screw that one, because that is just holding the antenna and it will not help you get the radio up. As we still have these screws holding it together, we must use some violence to get it open. I use these multi-tools to crack in. You see, I have already had this open once, so it's pretty easy, but the first time you really has to use much force to get it open. It might look a little bad afterwards, but that's okay. You have to pay something for making it able to play MP3s. But now it is almost opened up. Let's just see if we can get it open. Or is there still something in the way? Yeah, I found the screw. It's on the bottom side of the stereo. Has to get it open. And after that, just open the thing up. Look wonderful. Get it. Little more screwing. Here we have the thing. Let's take a look of what we will find inside. First, we have to locate the CD part, which is right here, and directly below it, we should find some interesting stuff. Like this is the audio cable transmitting audio from the CD player, which is right here, to the main board, which is over here. So like, this is our audio cable going from the CD player into the main board. So we want to take loose the audio cable from the CD player like this. You have to
cut it open. Then I have prepared something here. Then you should find a headphone you don't care too much about, because you are going to cut off these head earplugs, so you leave with a cable with a 3.5 millimeter plug in the one end and just a cable without these. This is exactly what I have done here. I have taken this old earphone with a 3.5 millimeter stereo plug. And here I cut the headphone off. Then I should solder it together with the cable I took loose from the CD player. So let's see how to solder this thing. So here we have the cables you are going to have. On the bottom we have the cable of the old earphone here and here, and on the upside we have the cable I took loose from the CD player. Here we have a blue cable which is going to a white cable here. Then we have the red cable here which should go to the red cable on the earphone. So these two go together, and the blue and the white. Then we have ground on both of these cables. The ground it looks white here, but it's not white. It's actually just a bare metal. It's not a colored plastic on it. And that should go to the ground here, which, you know, that is also not colored. It's just metal. I hope that made sense. So before we start soldering anything, I'm going to take loose the plug here. I guess it's not this simple as just taking it loose on all stores, but on this one I actually can take the contact loose, and that will make the soldering much simpler. But if you don't have the possibility to take it loose, then you don't really have to do it, but it really helps a lot. Here we see it much easier. Here on the bottom we have the cable of the earphone. This one I had already soldered. You see the ground to the ground, that's uncolored with uncolored. Then we have the blue one on the earphone with the white on the stereo. And then the red one is actually going to the red one on the earphone here. And lastly we have the ground for the other cable. We have ground in both of these cables coming from the earphone. So we are going to connect the ground from both of these to the same cable to the CD player. So that's why we are going to split it up to this. So let's start soldering. First, I'm going to take off the insulation of the cable I'm going to solder. This is, of course, the cable going to the stereo plug. There it goes. So here is the red cable to the left, which is going to the red cable here. And the ground, which doesn't have a color, it's just metal, is going to the other metal. Right on top of this one. So now we'll start soldering. I recommend that you tape the cables, right? That will make it a lot easier to solder later on. Just waiting for the solder iron to get warm. Let's see if the iron is heated. Yep, perfect. Now we can move on to the ground. Okay. Let's turn the solder iron off. Now I'm done soldering all the wires. Next you have to make sure the wires are not touching each other. That will make it a short circuit and nothing will work. So now it is pretty done. So I will take my power cord and search for the power wherever it is. It's here on the back. Like this. Then we plug it in a wall outlet. Then we have, as we connected cable to the CD, we got it to CD. It starts light. And then we have the cable here. So let's find some MP3 songs to play. Sorry. Should be more careful. And then we plug it in. Then we take some random song. Of course it shouldn't work. I know why it's not working. That's because the cable is just ending here. You remember? The plug here. Turn it off. You remember this one that we plugged out to make the soldering somewhat easier? Of course, we have to place it again like that. Make sure no cables are touching each other. Turn the power on, and we got sound. And volume knob. Is it working really awesome? To the tunes of Nyan Cat, we will put some electrical tape on the cable so they don't touch each other later in the future. That will make a short circuit and make you sound less. It will stop working, but it will not destroy anything, so don't worry about that. But you know, you have to take it up again if it's short circuit. Oh, you heard that? I actually short circuited it somewhat. You heard the sound became weaker for a minute moment, for just a second. When I put this together, you see the sound gets weaker. So try to insulate them from each other. And insulate all of them. Now I get some nice tape on the cable. Then I made a hole where it can come out like this. And then I just have to tape it there so it won't get distracted or something. That would be terrifying. Like that. Here the cable comes, and let's close the casing. Fit a screw. Yeah, it will be perfect. I think it's done. Let's play a song. First, I have to plug in the mains cable again. It to CD. The light will light up. Volume. And here we have the dynamic boost, which is currently enabled. Some find some song. I think we should take.
It's really good sound quality. It's perfect. If we think this is like 10 years old, at least.